Yes.
The media has support that this is a political government. It's a political measure. It will not have to. It is not the any poverty education or any caste recognition. It is solely for a political means.
I am in the favor of that being that an instrument for poverty eradication, because this is given on the basis of economic purpose.
I also support this topic of policy on poverty measures, because it is a type of agenda for the public of the Indian, because it is a previous type of the election.
I think it is totally a political measure, because according to its criteria, almost 80 to 90% of the general category persons are eligible for this 10% reservation. And if all the persons are eligible for this reservation, then what kind of benefit they will get? So I think it is totally a political reason.
I would like to go with the point B, an instrument for poverty eradication. For me, if government wants to do something for the people who are not covered under any reservation, then it's good, because as we have seen from very last years, there is no support for EWS people.
I think it is a policy that ensures symbolic caste representation in public institutions, because government is not giving them a reservation, they are giving a symbol to those people who are comes in the economies, they comes in the lower income level.
I will go with one political measure, because election time is near and it is possible it can be an agenda for political party to gain vote, and it is possible they are doing for their vote bank.
I do support the first point, that it is policy come political measure, because if it would not have been a political measure, there would have been some it would have been recommended to committee, because this lacks very much, as which I believe the capping level is way too high, which makes sense that okay, they want high amount of vote, and that's why they added that large and large amount would come to this purview, and that's why they can get a lot of votes.
Okay, so I am in favor of the second one, an instrument for poverty eradication, because according to me the current government has done very much for the people, so I think this is the one step for them also.
I will go with the second point, but I am against this statement, an instrument for the poverty eradication, but I am against it. They have set the criteria of 8 lakh per annum income, but if you divide it with 12, it comes with 66,000 per month. That is a handsome salary, I think, and that I don't believe he is a poor.
So your stance is?
I am against this statement and an instrument for poverty eradication.
Your
this
support
will not eradicate poverty.
You have to support. You have to support one point.
You can go against when you are supporting one.
I am supporting second, but I am against second and instrument. This is not an instrument.
To support the A or C.
Other two, I don't support other two.
So according to you, this policy is wasteless.
This policy
waste.
Is, yes, waste.
Waste. So it is waste, so this should be political measure then?
I don't agree that this is political measure, because it will benefit backward people.
But you have to choose one.
If I want to conclude that this is not a good system, but they have to bring some changes in this
exactly.
System.
This is what my point is. That's why this policy but ये तो टीवी का
इशू है
फिर तो ये पूरे में बोलेगा ना सो वी नीड टू क्लियर इट
चूज वन ए सेकंड
अगर मैं सेकंड फाइव चूजिंग सेकंड आई हैव टू स्पीक फॉर इन द फेवर बट आई डोंट वांट टू स्पीक इन
सो चूज द अदर टू ना बिटवीन अदर
आई डोंट वांट टू ओके
ऐसा नहीं होता है
ओके स्टॉप लाफिंग
I am supporting the political measure because of the clear agenda of gaining more political votes, because of voting maybe comes here, so it's a political measure.
I will go with the point first, means this is a political measure because election is near, and I think
in previous results from Supreme Court that we can't means accord. I'll go with Mandal Commission that we have not
choose your stance.
Policy come political measure.
To give this type of reservation on the basis of their economical backwardness. Okay, so this Modi government took a step to give this reservation on the economical back. Because I want to quote one thing on which I noted as well that when the success does not come by the need, your surname, then why the financial, why the poverty should? Okay.
But for this you have to amend in the constitution, Article 15, Article 16, as well as the part of DPSP Article 46, you have to amend this.
What does it need to amend this?
Because they hamper the basic structure of the constitution.
What is the basic structure?
The thing is, basic structure is defined by judiciary. And judiciary, in that case only, what you are talking about, Indira's only case, has decided that only 50% reservation can be given to them. And that reservation can be only based on socially and economically backward classes, which is written in the constitution in the Article 15 and 16.
So this is economically backward classes, na?
Socially and educationally backward classes, not only economic would be concerned. Economically is for
OBC. So we should also know that at the time of reservation, before the Mandal Commission, when Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar also sent for this reservation, it was for just only 10 years. But for last 16 years,
but still, that was this is not a case of whether reservation is fruitful or not. This is case whether this 10% economically backward classes reservation which is provided. So basically, what the point here is, this is just a political measure. I will tell you how. Since judiciary has decided that there would be capping of 50% limit. Okay, now they're exceeding that limit with so wide of view, which would be struck down by judiciary later on. So really they don't want. This would be struck down by judiciary because they have decided that they should be 50% capping. So ultimately the case would be, now they have lured the public, now they have lured the public by saying that okay, we will get the reservation. Later on it will be struck down by the judiciary and they can't. Since judiciary over here is stronger than the parliament, because they have this chance and through that check and balance, they can shut down this decision. So ultimately what will happen? They have lured, they have voted, and now what will happen? They will get nothing.
Also,
and if this was the Bharti
case. Also in case one of Bharti case, Supreme Court says that you can't change the basic structure and
exactly.
Basic and fundamental rights are the part of basic structure.
But
so
the basic structure is
more
defined that the 50% reservation should be given in the any part of the
constitution.
This is defined by the judiciary, which defines the basic structure of the constitution.
Actually, the judiciary is defining the basic structure. Okay, the judiciary got this power in that occasion, Bharti versus 1976 case.
Judiciary did not got this power, they gained this power.
They gain this power.
By themselves.
By themselves only. They gain this power. Okay, done. So I want to know that where it is written in the constitution itself, which was written in the
job with this, with the help of this reservation, automatically my next generation will not get that this reservation, because we will come above the economic class. I will be above 8 lakh per annum. That means I will automatically get out of this reservation. That means my future generation will not involve in this reservation.
Ultimately, so what you are doing is you are providing 90% population reservation of 10%, which again will include the competition, which is right now your
face. It is only a one-time benefit, but only
a
one-time benefit.
If I get
benefit from this reservation,
my next
generation will not be
able to get education will catch the moment. So the one who is not able to get education won't get reservation.
Line is to 6 lakhs. person to, if you are above 6 lakhs, you are out there outside the criminal area of the OBC. But person who is less than 8 lakhs, he was included in the reservation for.
How can they get a
person to get a legal idea without having a. First, they must have some basis, some, they must do some study, and they must
provide the study. Without study, they have come up with policy. Without any proper planning or without any proper logic, without any proper, you know, analyzing it properly.
The complete policy of political division, as he said earlier, election time is near and it is a agenda, political agenda of any political party. And yeah, as Vaishali ma'am said, if we go with a proper plan, with a proper plan, proper agenda, it can be successful. But we don't forget that there is great corruption in our country. So it is very difficult to go with this policy.
You have 30 seconds more.
And I want to say one more thing. Every coin has two faces or two sides. So if we see this policy, it has also two faces. One side is that it can be a political agenda, but we see other side of this policy. We can see how it will affect us as a common person, as a public, how it will affect public or us.
Okay. I think the bill which gives a quota to the economically backward people is something that helps us, because it's a first time that someone has think about such thing. It was first introduced in 8 January, and it was introduced by the Social Justice and Empowerment Minister, yes, Mr. Thawar Chand Gond. So the bill has involved some changes which involve Article 15, which said that there should be a quota for EWSC people, so that they can got a chance to get better education and jobs. So that instrument also has to remove the poverty as well. If someone has said that it's a political measure, so I think it's that they have no harm if the government wants to please us, because it's the government duty to do something for the benefit of the people. So I don't think it's any harm or it's not any political measure. And it's important for the people who really need it, because as we have seen that reservations are only based on social and economic education back.
Okay, I agree with this point I was supporting earlier. It is just a political measure, but if it would have been a proper policy, it would come up with proper plan. For example, it should be in that 50% reservation which is capped by a judiciary with the guidance of the constitution. What they can do is they can introduce creamy layer in SC reservation. Through that they can have some proportion of this, and ultimately the capping is way too high. If the capping is 6 lakhs for the OBC, then the capping should not be same, should not be above for the general category. So if these things would have given in mind and with proper analyzing and with proper planning this policy has came up with, and it can also help in poverty eradication. But now what has done it is just a policy. It is just a political measure, because ultimately the judiciary is going to suck it down, and this will just be a bait for the voters.
So as I said earlier, that the government has made this policy, so I think they have something in their mind. That's why they come up with this policy in that situation only. So I think this situation, this policy, this bill is going to only help the people of the economically backward classes.
I also support her statement. This policy or this reservation system will also help on mainly backward classes because they will be having reservation on the economic condition, and 66,000 per month I consider is a normal salary of a particular people considering the high prices of the metropolitan cities. 66,000 per month is low for a single person earning in a home. So this is a good reservation system.
I think this is a political measure because you can see means we have to eradicate the reservation slowly and slowly. Okay, so if you want to make a beneficial means act, then there should be a criminal SC and ST, and gradually means we have to remove and make.
I think it should be made for the it's a main agenda to the remove our poverty in general category. But in the other hand, we can find out they have some defects inside the policies, because of if we don't make now it's a limitations, then we can get now bad defects also.
I appreciate that the government is so much concerned regarding the poverty of this country, and they have made the policy so early. But what I wanted to say is that poverty reduction is must, it is necessary in a country, but reservation is not the answer for that. Reservation has some different purpose, and for different persons it was introduced with different ideas and different aspirations. It was simple. And regarding that, one of our friend was saying that the government do time to time studies that after 10 years that if reservation has completed its objective or not, and every government finds that it still the reservation is not able to reach where it should have been. That's why government always give after 10 years extension to the reservation as according to the constitution. That's why it is only a policy, or I can say only a political measure to get the vote banks, and if they want it, because it is just like to giving them something in return, but also not giving them anything. That's why I totally disagree with
you. I think that this amendment is very good for the benefits of our country. And secondly, if it comes with some new changes, new amendments like 125th Amendment, 126th Amendment, so the new changes can be this financial aid should. They should put down some more limits on this, and should make some more filters, and also they should have a check on this fake makings of Aadhaar and what we call that BPL cards, because some people are using this type of cards, reservation cards, in a wrong way.
First of all, I think this is a political measure because election time is coming and we can't be more there. And second step, it is not an instrument for eradication of poverty, because poverty cannot be eradicated by the reservation. Poverty can be eradicated by when the people get the job and he save the money by the institution, government institution and government hospitals. Because when they come in government schools or hospitals, they save some money. So it is not a step of poverty education, it is a like of a vote bank measure.
I think it is not a policy, it is a lollipop for the general public, which is given by the government, and it is already in the pocket of public, and government puts it out from their pocket and give again it to the general public. But I think if certain amendments can be done in it, like the 8 lakh criteria of income is reduced, then it will be benefit for the public.
I think everyone talk about only point A and point B. Maybe it is true that it will be a political measure and it will help the poverty eradication. But what about the symbolic we are giving to the government, giving to the public? We already facing people who are from SC and ST, and those who are belonging different religions. They are treated differently from different caste people. Now you are giving a symbol of 10% or 15% reservation to those people. So it also enhances these things of racism, you can say racism. So I think maybe it is small in comparison of A or B, but it is true that government is giving us symbolic to those people who are comes in the below line poverty.